I got this test set up to measure the friction in the needle eye. And what I got here is just a weight down here that pulls in the thread, and it goes up through the machine directly up here with no hook in the machine, and it goes up through the needle eye there and further up to a dynamometer there. Now I'm going to show you when I pull up this dynamometer and let it go down. The last part of the video will show test results. The left scale here is in Newton, and I'm holding the weight now. The weight is 1.17 Newton when it's in free air. Now I lift the weight up. Now you can see that I pull with about 1.5 Newton when it goes up. Perhaps a little more. And now I try to let it go down again. And you can see it's about 0.9 Newton when I go down. And that was a good needle. It suited very well. Now I'll show you a bad needle. So this is a new needle, but I have tried it and it immediately frayed the thread. So now I'm trying to lift the weight up here, and you see that it got some, but maybe about 2.2 Newton or something like that. And now I try to descend it again. And when I descend it, it's about 0.7 Newton or something like that. So this needle eye has significantly higher friction to the thread. The machine itself also do some friction. And now I'll try to show you this. This is when I pull up just through the machine with no needle. And now I descend it. Okay. So there you see what the friction is. I made a change to my test setup using an alternative little needle holder here. And this way I becomes independent on what friction the sewing machine may add to the thread. Such a needle holder can be made in many ways. I shall try to show you how it is made. You got here a steel thread holding the needle there, and here on the other side a steel thread coming through, and you have got a wooden wedge here. So if I pull this wedge out, the needle gets loose and I can change the needle here. That's how it works. The thread I used is a Serifil 20 thread. It's a 635 polyester thread. And the needles I used is both relative new needles and from a company called Flying Man, a Chinese company, and I know these needles can have issues. And I got them from two different batches. I also did a close-up photo of the needles here. You got the good needle to the left and the two better needles to the right. And you can see a difference in finish here. But I've not been able to directly recognize when something is wrong with a needle this way. But it is a possibility to make such close-up photos of them too. This is a FAF30 machine, and the stroke of the take-up lever there is about 68 millimeters, and it is similar on all domestic sewing machines. It means that the thread is passing the needle eye with about 135 millimeters of thread up and down for each stitch that is made. And therefore this friction of the needle eye becomes important, because it adds quite much to the whole performance if you got too much friction there. Here you see a number of different sewing machine needle brands. Perhaps you don't need to worry about friction in needle eye if you got a reputable needle brand. But sometimes you cannot get all kinds of needles, and therefore you might have to buy from somebody else. One example is this needle here is from a company called Wright Eckert, and it's a 140/22 needle for leather work and for household machines. It might be that you cannot find that specific needle in this size from normal needle brands. So it can be necessary to check the quality of the needles like I did before. I like to add that this is not the only quality parameter. There can be a lot of other things that is important for a needle. The test results are shown in this table for larger needles tested with a TEX 135 thread. To the right, you see the friction ratio for the thread moved up and moved down at needle eye. It is the friction force divided by the mean value of the two thread tensions applied to the needle and in percent. The tested needles from Schmetz got predictable results. Most of the tested needles are for the company Flying Man. The needles received in 2014 seems reasonable, but do have some variation results. Most of the needles received in 2020 got significantly higher friction, and most of them seems not able to be used. The tested needles from Wright Eckert do also have quite big variation in their performance. I guess you should not accept needles with a friction ratio above 35%. This is the results for the medium-sized needles tested with a TEX 70 thread. Most of the needles are usable because they got friction ratios below 35%. But many of the needles from Flying Man, Wright Eckert and a no-name brand got higher relative friction ratios than the other brands of needles measured. As you have seen, it's easy to make these measurements, and I have seen a direct relation between the friction of the needle eye measured and how the sewing machine will perform. I hope you found the results interesting, and you are welcome to leave your comments and questions.